When they came to us, they were weedy, sallow, skinny, frightened children, the refuse of our industrial system, and they were in very poor condition and had to be made into soldiers.
Many of us had given our own ages to join the army.
The adjutant walked down the lines and gave an order that every man under the age of 19 should take 2 paces forward. Nobody moved.
Yeah, I was a lad of 17, and they'd probably say I wasn't 19, which you had to be to join up. But he says, how long do you want to sign on for?
Everybody else was joining up, so I went into the recruiting office. He said to me, how old are you? I said, 17, sir. Yeah. Well, he said, go outside and come back and say you're 18. So, of course, I went outside and said, we're 18. Went straight up the C400.
The sergeant said, how old are you? I said, I'm 18 and 1 month. He said, do you mean 19 and 1 month? So I thought a moment. I said, yes, sir. He said, write a sign here, please.
He asked me how old I was, and I said I was 16 in March. Oh, he said, you're too young. You better go outside and have a birthday.
I was 16 years old in 1917, and I was 6'2" tall, and my father allowed me to go. So I entered my age as 19 years old, 3 years older than what I really was.
I was 15 years, just 2.5 years short of 18. And I got before this medical officer who said, all right, you pass.
I was just turned 17 at the time, and I went up to Whitehall and enlisted in the 16th Lancers.
I was 15, and I thought I'd have a better chance than when I was 14. So I walked into the barracks and just said, I'm 18, and that was it.
My parents wrote to the commanding officer and asked for me, as I was underage, to be released. And he said, your parents want you back. Do you want to go? I said, no.
The chaplain asked me my age, and I said, I was 16. He said, much too young. Would you like me to pray for you?